And this is it. Evil. He's ready as well. The match is going to be starting. It is the winner bracket final. Evil from Russia. Rapha from America. It is set. Rapha's going to be getting top yellow to begin with. Moving himself over to that red armor rapidly. And obviously Evil going to be getting that mega side of the map. He's going with the plasma, but hitting absolutely nothing. Rapha has dodged so much of this, but he's going on the bounce pad. And Evil's going to snag the first frag. He's only got 10 health remaining. Is he able to
hold himself with it? He needs to listen for the spawn. He needs to figure out where Rapha's going to be and find his 25s and 50s. He's going to be relatively safe here. Of course, neither player will have a rail for quite some time, so Evil can create a little bit of distance, grab away that yellow armor. We have Mega coming up here pretty soon, but it's another fight over the key, and one that this time Evil cannot show up to. Fortunately, that's going to buy him a Mega, but not for very long, as Rapha's going to be barreling down on him, completely out of armor, just having to backpedal as fast as he can, throwing down some defensive rockets and looking for a way out. Unfortunately, he's taken almost all the health on the map already, so he's got very little to recover on, so he's just going to have to out-sneak Rapha here.
Massive pressure on Evil at the moment. He's had just so little to work with, and Rapha's really trying to cut him off at every opportunity.
So, yeah, you were talking about how Rapha plays out of position, out of control of the key for a little while. Now we have to see how Evil deals with the very same situation.
I'm actually impressed that he's done this well to get himself essentially 100-100. I think that's fantastic for him.
Backing out of lower yellow armor, not easy. I think you only did 2 damage on that one rocket. But here's Rapha launching out with the shaft once again. Evil getting back over to mid. Looking to do a little bit of damage before Rapha puts his sights on the red armor. But that was a solid rocket, but now Evil cannot afford to take any real damage here whatsoever. And his dancing around the pillars is just beautiful here. I'm so surprised he hasn't died yet. Even if he does die here, he's going to be doing a lot of damage to Rapha. So even with the red armor coming up, he might have an opportunity to cut him off at the mega. And Rapha's going to know that. I think he's going to maybe try to not engage there. Yeah.
Evil's actually going to get it. That's very well done from him. But the problem is that Rapha's still got the key,
yep,
of course.
Yep.
And Evil's lost his lead, so I wonder what he's going to be able to do now. That damage there, Evil all of a sudden lost the majority of his stack. And Rapha, with the railgun now, able to play all distances of the game.
Yeah, it turns a little less into rail control and more, okay, well, if you want to go get the rail, I'm going to go get everything else right now. So it really does buy you that good 10 seconds of being able to move into a better position on the map, which is exactly what Rapha's done. He's looking for a little bit of damage on Evil before he gets baited into the teleporter. He's actually going to go down below, so Rapha can now leave and keep his back to Mega. He's put himself in such a position where no matter how the fights go, no matter how the damage goes, he can't really lose out on any of the items. So really well played there. That's exactly how to get first rail.
Is that maybe a little bit of a choke point that he's not going to be able to chase through? Rapha's going to try and cut him off. There, solid rail there from Evil. And actually, with the damage from the rocket jump as well, Rapha is not in the best of shape at the moment. That red is up. Is Rapha going to be able to steal it? And have Evil had a chance to pick up the railgun as well? He would have.
Yep.
There's one rocket. Oh, it doesn't hit the second one. Rapha, he gets the damage, but Evil comes back at him.
Evil might have some incentive to go aggressive here. There he is, flying up to get the crab on the mega health. What a jump. What a bit of LG. And that's going to put him back in the lead here, 2-on-1. He's got a decent amount of health here, but Rapha is looking fairly angry afterwards and might be wanting to push in on the key. I'm not sure he could really justify that, though. He's going to need a rocket launcher. But Evil going to be able to keep the top of the map here. And that's going to be a decent rail on the red.
This damage from Evil's been amazing. He's going to try to drop down onto him. He doesn't get the frag. Rapha's on 12 points of health. He was just desperate for it. Rapha was still having ownership over that key. And there's a machine gun. I think Evil.
Where's the LG? Where's the LG? He's looking for it.
Again, 12 health. And Rapha, he's going to have the 50 health level as well to take, making sure he doesn't create it on any level there. And he's even going to be able to load up with that railgun as well. Evil got himself a yellow, got Mega. Is he going to be able to get red? Has he got important weapons enough? Oh, hello, Evil.
He didn't want to stick around for that fight, and I certainly can't blame him. But that's going to buy him a red armor. Rapha didn't come around the corner so eagerly to punish him for that red, so he's going to be fairly all right there. Rapha's still a little bit weak after that entire last engagement, but he's looking for upper YA. He's still got the key. He can still move to Mega at will. But now we've got split timing across Mega and Red. So Rapha might have some incentive to stay in mid here for a little bit.
I wonder what Evil's going to do about this, actually. Obviously, it's annoying him because he hasn't got the key. So yep, Rapha gets to make that decision. But I think that rail is really important to make sure he's not benefiting too much from picking up these items. But Here's the teleporter being used, but can't quite land the shot.
It's going to put them at a slightly even keel right now as they're looking for rails across the back hallway. Rapha just daring Evil to show up. But they're at a, for the first time in a long time, they're actually at fairly even stacks. And while Rapha has advantage with the key and the top of the map, neither of them really want to engage until they get some of these initial rails in. And with Rapha not really getting any response on that, that makes this red armor a little bit more risky. Yeah, he's just going to play it safe, going for the mega, but that does open up a free red for Evil.
Right, Evil needs to continue getting just that chip damage to make sure Rapha is not able to get up to that a solid stack.
Rapha nice.
Finds him. Always sketchy. Oh, lovely rail shot at the end there. Always sketchy, though, that the players are going to be falling down to that lava pit, because you're not going to be escaping if you fall down in that part of the map.
Evil doesn't fall.
Ouch.
Solid rocket, so Evil's definitely going to be on his back late, but he really needs to do at least a little bit of damage on Rapha on the red armor pickup. Didn't really get what he wanted, and that's going to be a fourth frag up for Rapha.
I don't know how Rapha navigated that whole fight. He just seemed to be damaged very slowly, but over time it amounted to a huge amount, and the resources just weren't popping up fast enough for Evil to stack up. I think that's a pretty big deal at this point. Now Rapha's 200-200. He's got all the weapons he needs. Evil hoping for the best. He lands two rails in a row, but he's giving up another frag. And here on Elder, three frag lead, that is so difficult to get, let alone playing it against Rapha.
It just takes so long for Evil to get to a state where he can do real damage against Rapha, especially when he's nailing rails like that. Yeah, as you can see, he's currently at 43 on the rail. He's hitting a lot of really critical ones, ones where Evil wants to push in and do a little bit of damage, but Rapha says no. And so now that he's got a little bit of a stack advantage and he can keep cycling the items, he still might just be searching for the fight. But Evil, he knows that, you know, he might need to spend a couple frags, he might need to take a few bad fights in order to whittle Rapha down, but then he'll need to grab a rail, a rocket, and just get back up on the board.
Evil managed to get a bit of good damage at the beginning there, but yeah, when you've got no health and armor remaining, then you're not going to be continuing that fight for very long. I already feel that Evil's actually given too much to try and get that control.
Yeah.
He stopped wanting to play that slow game a little too soon, but yeah, after you've given up three frags, maybe he just felt a bit under pressure.
Well, it's going to be the final 3 minutes here, and yeah, Rapha with a fairly comfortable lead now. And again, the way he's been playing, anytime he feels like he can't really afford a challenge for an item, he's more than happy to leave it up for Evil, because he knows that, at least so far, he's been able to hit just about every important rail, and Evil just hasn't had the opportunities for that.
I think those important fights earlier on that Evil's going to be maybe thinking about a little too much about what could have happened if something else was done, where he had the lead for a short period of time. I still think, though, that it's the key that really was the critical factor in it. The fact that Evil was never able to get the key every time he killed Rapha, it just gave Rapha the control. He knew that as long as he could get that item, he was able to master a plan slowly enough to get himself back in control and take the lead. And we've got Rapha just chasing down Evil once again. That is 10-2. And this first map of the winner bracket's final best of five.
So we have to go back to your previous prediction about Rapha taking this one. You know, fairly on point. I'm a little bit surprised to see, you know, not enough rails coming out of Evil around those corners. But as you can see, Rapha's been anticipating a lot of those poke shots and denying them before they're even started.
Yeah, I mean, Evil even needed more than just the rails. He needed a whole lot to happen. Rapha's just far too intelligent with his defensive play. And with that access here to this door to the right, and he's able to weave wherever he likes and apply pressure to the items that Evil's going for with relative ease.
I mean, the rails are sort of critical for Evil, just because the way that Rapha's been playing, he's making it very difficult for Evil to get close. You can see Evil trying to jump in with LG, Plasma, and Rockets, but Rapha's making it very difficult for Evil to get a nice distance there, so highly impressed by this. But yeah, that'll be map one going down. Do we know what map two's going to be?
Unfortunately, I haven't had that confirmed with me. Although I know that Evil, if his pick afterwards, wouldn't mind going for a blood run. Also depends on what these guys have removed as well. Although I believe it's pick-pick, drop-drop, pick-pick in terms of the select map selection order.
So just a note here, it's way too late, but this is what Evil wanted to happen a bit earlier. You know, just kind of go aggressive, get in some damage, keep Rapha low, and be able to
a good fight for him,
take man. Items, corner him, because he's been able to find him at Mega. You know, Rafa's been kind of hugging the Mega the whole time. It's what got him on the board in the first place. And so if he could do that, take a red, and then get in close again, then he certainly could turn that into control. But too little, too late, and it's going to be 2 on 13.
That's it, and I've just been told that Sinister is going to be map number 2, definitely a map that's going to be more favorable for Evil, I think, in the way that he's able to balance the control down.
Here we go.
Evil's ready. He's hit the button, and we're going to be starting no Bs for him. It's all Ls, and this is map 2 of the winner bracket final here at QuakeCon 2016. We're on Rafa to begin with, and immediately a little bit of damage from below, just maybe slightly unexpected from Rafa. But Evil should be able to navigate his way to that mega health.
Just a helpful nudge, you know. He's seen Rafa fall on that jump before, so he wanted to make sure that he made it to the other side. So Rafa's looking to return the favor now. Evil's trying to throw down a few rails and actually getting quite rewarded for it. Unfortunately for Evil, Rafa can recover on the 50 health. Now completely out of armor before the fight for the next red comes up. So it's a risky one. And Rafa ends up taking a one-frame rail through the teleporter. Beautiful timing on that shot from Evil. And that allows Evil to stomp around the map a little bit more aggressively.
And Rafa's going to go up to that top yellow and find that nothing's there. I think his timing in a second is going to be telling him that Rafa missed the opportunity. Evil been and gone already. And he did that very quickly. He didn't even hang around to wait to see if Rafa would go there. Now, I wonder if Evil's going to be delaying the timing for the items. He hasn't at all. It's a complete clash, which he's been wondering, what has Evil got planned up for the next rotation of those big items?
I'm a little bit surprised he didn't delay that, just because Rafa was in no position to attack, and Evil certainly didn't see him there, so he waited, you know, 2-3 seconds to give himself a little bit of a buffer, just because you can make that link between Red and Mega fairly quickly here, even though it's an incredibly risky route. But Rafa's going to get in on this Red. Evil's looking for the rails, and so far his rails are much more consistent than they were in Elder, so Rafa's once again low, but still fighting on this one, but Evil's chasing on the jump pad. I'm not sure what he expected to get out of that.
Very risky play from Evil. It could have paid off, but what was strong from him is that he was able to actually disengage as quickly as possible.
Right.
But at the same time, he might have, during that time, been able to get himself the yellow that Rafa just got. He has at least pressured on the red and taken that item. His rails have actually been sublime. He's been putting some excellent pressure and forcing Rafa to continue that defensive play. And but when those items did clash, I felt that actually Evil was just looking for the damage at that point.
Yeah.
It was almost something that he wanted, that for Rafa to commit to one of the items.
Absolutely. So now, every time Rafa's been put up against the ropes, he's been able to recover to that 50 health. That's someplace that Evil needs to find him and punish him on. So he's going to be so focused on these items, and Rafa's going to punish him for sticking around so long. Red's going to be up. Rafa is a short jump away from it here. Evil's going to need to run a little bit longer, but he can get back up the stairs maybe a little quicker. But now he's still sticking around here. He's daring Rafa to drop down and try to push through the teleporter.
He's going to go for that red at some point. He's been leaving it up a long time, and that Mega's going to be up shortly after. It's still over there. And Evil hasn't gone and taken it. He's just left it up. It's like, what the hell? I don't want it right now. But he's got to get to that Mega. Rafa's not able to pressure it enough. He does not land that last rail. Eventually gets away to that yellow. We're seeing some pretty high-level stuff from Evil in just trying to keep that map control and see if Rafa is going to make a move for him to get any further damage.
This is actually beautiful because Rafa the whole time was, you know, doing his conservative thing and going, all right, it's too risky for me to go to red. Mm-hmm. I'm going to clash with Evil there, so I won't go to red. Problem is, Evil never went to red, so you could see Rafa kind of like locking up a little bit. Like,
I like that he checked that the red was still up. Is the red still there? Like, there's only one thing. He must still be at Mega. It's way too close to its spawning. Rafa did get to the red armor, but immediately takes damage and is put essentially where he was just a second ago.
And that'll certainly help out, though. But yeah, the peak damage from Evil's been much more consistent here so far. Rafa is going to be looking for 25 and maybe even the 50 here. But it's a 7 health 50. He doesn't want to take it right now. It's been so important to his recovery ability here so far.
I'm going to watch Evil a bit and see what he's going to get up to. I think that was right by the 50 health bubble that Rafa was hiding. Evil spots him out.
Well, if he does spot him there too much, he's going to get clued in on that. Evil's going to be trying to hash this Mega here. He's going to get it. And with Rafa where he is, he's going to be able to get over to that red pretty quickly. It's going to be shaft on shaft. Evil doing quite a bit of damage. and trying to cut him off and meet him down here at lower yellow armor. But again, Rafa is just not wanting to get into any engagement that he doesn't know for certain he can top.
Evil's putting, nice. Has been putting maximum pressure on that mega health, and that rail maybe means that next mega will be very hard to get. He's got to win this red armor cleanly, but it means that it's so late for him to get over to that mega.
Wow.
He just about misses that rail, and I think he's going to get pressure. Rapha is going to be attacking very quickly. The rockets are so solid from Evil. He can't quite get the kill in time. A rail out from Rapha, but he switches weapon in time and gets himself the first frag.
Fantastic aggression. You know, Evil knew that Rapha was going to be showing up on that mega. You could see it in Rapha's movement there, but coming in just that early, just at the right time with those initial rockets, keeping Evil from getting out of the water puddle, absolutely brutalizing. So halfway through, we're looking at one frag, and the pace of this game is going to change now, as Evil now has to create situations where he can take a frag.
But what was genius about that from Rapha is it was all about that one rail he landed before red was taken by Evil, because it meant that Evil had to take the red armor, and he was no longer able to apply pressure or ownership over the mega health. And that was really what his game was focused about, is I've got the mega, you don't. We've basically, armor doesn't even matter at this point. And he said, okay, he had to take the red with about 6 or 7 seconds left to get back to the mega, and that was enough time for Rapha to get in his way and provide a choke point. And just, even though the rockets were amazing from Evil, Rapha was still able to get his way there.
And perhaps the problem from Evil there was that, with that situation in mind, he wasn't willing to give up the mega after taking the red. You know, I think that's something that, looking at our last match on Elder, that's something that Rapha would have done in that situation.
Yeah, I think the switch, I think Evil would really like to Rapha to have held that railgun out to go for another shot, which meant that him committing with the lightning gun was absolutely fine. But otherwise, Evil, with 4 minutes to conjure up something here, he's managed to find about 100 armor, but that's gone.
Yeah, and what also has been gone is the initial rails coming out of Evil. I mean, he's going to need them for sure now. So Rapha is going to be fully stacked up, daring Evil to show up. In fact, he can push out here. This is good. He can put a lot of aggression on Evil here. He was hoping to get a trade on the Mega, but he's not going to allow that to happen. So then Rapha can get the frag, he can get the Mega, and now he can get red. So that was a really good read. And now things are even more tense for Evil here.
Evil trying to get some rockets, go up close and personal to make sure that Rapha does a little bit damage to himself as well, but he is down in the negatives. He misses the rail. Oh, he does get a second one, though. But is he able to get away from here?
Two more rails would do it. There aren't any items up for a little bit. Rapha doesn't have any yellow to recover on, but Evil's so incredibly weak, he needs to find some 25s or something.
Rapha needs a rail as well. I mean, he ran out of that, which is a little bit of an issue for him, but he's not actually going to commit into this mega. He's going to let Evil take it, but Evil's just dancing all over the place.
Dancing, but not connecting with any of those rockets, unfortunately. So Rapha's going to be able to recover a lot faster than him. It's not good news for Evil.
That's cool.
Coming up on the red armored platform, if Evil's LG's on point, he can keep it from making the jump, but Rapha was just happy to stand there and hit just about every single cell. Absolutely insane.
You haven't got more health than me. Evil may be standing in the wrong position just there. Does hit a pretty sick rocket, but you're hoping for a lot more at this time. There's not a huge amount more to be so positive about for Evil. Mega is up. He does get himself there, but the vertical rail from Rapha is going to shut that one down. There's Evil. He gets a yellow, he's not going to be near that red for the time being, and Rapha just needs to stabilize a little bit. 2 minutes is enough to make a comeback, but if Rapha's able to get back up to 200-200, I'm feeling that he should be safe.
I'm starting to have flashbacks of last year with Evil, on Sinister, actually, where there would be situations where, because of the last fight, it wouldn't have been a good idea to put pressure on the red, but Evil just wasn't willing to give it up. You know, he thinks that a bit of aggression can go a long way, and in some cases it certainly can, but against Rapha, maybe he's not the right guy for that.
Yeah. Let's go to Evil for potentially one last time here, because I think the next attack, be it successful or unsuccessful, probably going to be the... what he needs. Or doesn't need.
Doesn't have much time either way there. Yeah. So Evil is going to be trading rails here, and those aren't trades that he wants. He wants to be able to corner Rapha. Well, you know, that might actually be good for Evil.
You're probably right, to be honest.
He doesn't need to be chasing right now.
Just get the red. But, you know, a minute and 15. Yeah. I mean, I've seen some pretty extraordinary comebacks in time casting, but I'm just not sure it's going to happen. But partially because of immense rockets like this, but also because even if Rapha does get a frag, Evil does get a frag, then Rapha's going to be able to have such a strong defensive game Rapha trying to push Evil away, and another direct rocket just as his health ticked down to 100. That's going to be GG, 5-1. And Rapha's reign over Evil continues. This is it. Evil has to make his claim here. It is map 3 of the winner bracket final, QuakeCon 2016. And we are going to begin on Evil's point of view. We've got a weapon straight away from Rapha, and he has just hit like 100% plasma right there. That was absurd. A quick lead for him. And he hasn't gone for the mega yet, or the top yellow. Yeah. Rapha, is he going to grab everything right now?
Yeah, Evil has to secure this because as much damage as he could do with machine gun, he knew that, you know, when Rapha kills me, he's going to be able to take yellow, he's going to be able to take some health, and he can move right into the mega. So Evil had to put some pressure on him. But it won out. You know, Rapha's 100-100, and there's the second red going over to Evil. So all in all, that machine gun play worked out all right. It's a tough spawn to react to, and he did all right. Yeah. Whiffs on both rails there, as we have already kind of really close timing between Mega and Red. That's what you get with those adjacent spawns.
Like Evil maybe wants to commit to the Mega as well. I wonder if he wants to take ownership over that item again and place equal importance as he did on Sinister.
Yeah, so they go for a trade there, which puts a lot of the focus of the fight back on the initial damage and these peak rails. Is a decision that apparently Evil was okay with. Didn't want to go too aggressive here, even though now he already needs to make up that first frag. So Rapha top of the map, it's going to be a long time before Mega comes back up. He's going to be maybe pushing in from the bottom onto Red, and just looking for the one rail. Two rails, actually, geez, coming back in for it. One more shot, Itis, but Evil's going to be hurting for it. And again, he takes damage and he goes, all right, but it's still time to fight for the item. It's item o'clock.
Wow, so shots that they're both landing are crazy. Evil going to the LG. He tries to go for a push to the Mega, puts Rapha down to 10 points of health.
This is okay. He can still grab a rocket launcher maybe and show up at the Red. Yeah, this is still really risky for Rapha to drop in on. But this is the difference between Rapha and Evil. Evil would have dropped there. Rapha did not.
Has he done enough damage to make him available? Oh, it's not going to matter at this point. He's no longer setting out for that that frag straight away. The one good thing for Evil right now, though, even though he's losing frags, he's quickly able to establish himself on the map again by getting some resources. And Furious Ice is fairly friendly to that, depending on what kind of control the opponent's got. Red's going to be up. Rapha is going to have easy access to the Mega straight away. Actually gets knocked off the pillar a little bit. I don't think Evil would have recognized that that happened.
I mean, he would have heard the hit beep, so maybe you assume that Rapha still made it back over top. But that allows Rapha to get a fairly clean pick of the Mega. And now he's just looking for him in this atrium for a bit of a fight. He's like, all right, I've got a great stack. Time to burn a little bit, earn some damage. Gonna go be a little bit quiet, and Evil's gonna find him at the 50 health, but not where he expected to find him. That's a lot of LG damage that Rapha just took off there, so now Evil cannot push in on this Red. And Rapha's trying to see if he can get some more free damage before he commits to it, which creates some comfortable timing before going over to Mega. Evil's already gonna be up there, but he really can't afford to stay there. Hopefully, he can do some real damage here, but it's not gonna happen.
Rapha is all over him. He's going to be able to get the Mega now. There's only a lower yellow in the railgun room at the moment that Evil can get. I wonder even if he even feels safe to get that. Rapha's got his position, looking for a shot at the top, but can't quite make it. Good to at least take the opportunity to have a go.
All right, so as the chaos kind of settles down here a little bit, Evil needs to kind of, you know, recommit himself to the yellows and then just do some pop shots on these Megas and Reds.
That's such a dangerous area to be in. Evil's got to fight his way out of it as well. There's 10 seconds left until that Mega.
Fantastic LG, however.
That actually was an enormous damage. I did not even recognize how much he had had done at that point. Evil would like to delay Rapha a bit of the Mega just to secure the Red more easily, but it looks as if Rapha's just going to forfeit it. He's going to get timing on the item.
Yep.
And he's hoping that this yellow's not been taken yet, but it has been. So Evil gaining a little bit of time around the map to get maybe some other weapons. And maybe even get a push on Rapha to be a bit more successful, because everything for the last, was two maps worth of time has been all about Rapha.
Absolutely. In fact, you know, switching over to Evil here would be bad. He's got the two pickups of the red armor here. And he's actually going to try to cut off Rapha on mid-map, you know, make it more difficult for him to recover onto the 50 health. It's going to be good. He's going to be able to take that Mega, but he's dropping down instead here, kind of disengaging from the fight, looking for a little bit of time before this yellow armor comes up. But that does somewhat give Rapha this side of the map at the moment. He's going to be looking for him here at the red armor. Going to have to see if Evil can get a third one here. Rapha's going to be, you know, there, technically, but he's going to leave it up.
Evil's got full control right now.
Yeah.
What is Rapha going to do? He's going to be able to find him. Good rocket, but the LG is going to work. Evil is on the board. He should be able to retain that control as well. Mega up in a moment. But he wants to put some pressure down. Let's see if... Oh, no. No. It's the other way, Evil. And he's just realized that he hasn't got time to get one and then the other. What kind of plays are you going to make? He's found Rapha now.
Rapha was expecting him at the Mega, so we stuck around to look for him.
That
you can
well
see that Evil's going, all right, I need to not focus on the item so much. I need to find Rapha and do some damage. I have an opportunity to do that, but knowing which item to avoid
was
the problem. Yeah,
there's a bit of a mess for Evil. He could have had both of the items, but he has maintained knowledge of the timings, and he just has to fight a bit more of a stacked Rapha. Getting some long-range damage at the moment would be critical.
He can breathe here. He's still got a good stack.
And he's got a good amount of time as well.
Yeah. And he was able to find Rapha right around the corner and do a ton of damage without really taking any for his first frag, which against Rapha is no small feat. So, Evil stacking back up on yellow, going to be trading some rails, getting another one just as Rapha disappears around the corner. That's going to make this next red very difficult for Rapha to justify presence on. But he knows that he wants to create a little bit more comfort. He knows that Evil is going to be stacking up and going to be getting more and more aggressive here. So it's going to be Mega and Red traded off.
Evil really trying to let go of the items and not feel as if they control his positioning too much. But Rapha is just about to survive more often than not, and the damage that he's doing, yellow is taken by Evil, but he's being weakened quite a lot. He's trying to keep Rapha out of that choke point, does move him back, and should be able to pick up the next red armor, but that was very close to actually Rapha winning an important fight. It doesn't matter if either of them got fragged, it was just whether or not Rapha was able to secure the next major items without any issues. Red for Evil.
What is Evil's plan here? Well, if Rapha didn't drop down, he could have recovered back over to the 50 health, so Evil's going to try to cut him off here. Maybe force him back over towards grenade launcher.
Oh, that was
He's
such
gonna
a chance.
He's going to climb
out the rail. He's not hitting anything, though, at the moment. Red will go to Evil. It was an important rail that he hit over at the mega health because that stopped Rapha from being able to position himself on the red.
Yeah, this is good. For the first time in a while, Evil kind of created a no-lose situation for himself. He's going to try to get some damage, and if he doesn't, oh well, I'm going to grab Red, and I still have time to cut him off at the 50 if he decides to go for that.
Oh, he's dropping down! Absolutely devastating move from him. How is he going to be able to get himself up to the Mega? He might have to just forfeit this and try and get out. Rapha also having a bit of trouble. This extra damage that Evil's landing. Every item is up, and they've broken away from each other. Evil may be a little bit thankful for that he didn't lose more health in that circumstance. And the LG, this is where he got his first kill. He's just going to go for it. The rocket goes through the floor, and Rapha wins the fight! 4-1, and Evil cannot make it happen at all. That rocket is so close. I think this step really helped him out there. More rockets coming out. Rapha, full dodge mode.
Ironically enough, that wasn't a great rocket.
Rapha delighted to escape with the yellow. Oh, the direct rocket! He's back in the game a little bit. He knew he had to make something count rapidly. And he did not want to turtle this game anymore. I think Evil's just got to turn the heat up. He's known for being so aggressive in the European matches, and I think he's just given Rapha far too much respect.
He can certainly justify it now that he's done a bit of damage, gotten back up on the board. You know, it's one thing to try to turn up the heat when Rapha hasn't taken a frag at all, but now Rapha's going to have to react to a lot of what Evil's doing, and it's going to come down to how many defensive rockets and rails Rapha can throw out, which so far from what we've seen is a hefty amount. So hopefully for Evil, he can keep the pace up without having to be forced to slow things down. Which might be the case here since we have split timing between Red and Mega. But they're going to find each other at Red, and Rapha does not want to go for that. He wants to trade it off with Mega and go, all right, fine. No worries for me. We're going to trade this. We're both going to get stacked back up, and everything's going to be the way it was.
Rapha's got a whole bunch of things that he just took from this room. That's 150 extra damage that Evil needs to do to Rapha to get himself a frag. And there's just over 60 seconds left.
It's going Evil for a chase here.
He's leaving it very late.
Can third time be the charm? 1 minute on this corner, no, Rapha's not even going to be there. He might not even go to that corner anymore. Too risky.
Oh, the rockets, though, that Rapha's landing on him. That red armor, is he going to be able to take it? Evil's ticked out on all the damage, and his rockets are out. His life is out. That is 5-2. And Evil, you can see him there looking a little bit uncomfortable, and I think that's really the moment. Evil's calling GG, and we are going to have Rapha in the grand finals later today. What a play from Rapha. He's just got a perfect counter.
You could see how much they were trying to to get into each other's heads. Mm-hmm. They were playing each other way more than they were playing the map, than they were playing the items.
Yeah.
I think Rafa did a little bit better.
Yeah. Well, I think he won, so.
I think so, yeah. Well, you could just see that Evil was trying to trip up Rafa, but I think he just ended up double-guessing himself a few cases.
I feel like Evil feels that he has to play a different style to beat Rafa, and you can see that he's playing a very cautious, careful style. Of course, Evil is not out of the tournament. That was only the winner bracket. So he is going to go down to the loser bracket, where I believe he's going to face up against the winner of 0-4 and Kiilstofte. So the Russian is still in for the running.